Recently, Kanye West tweeted, "I love the way Candace Owens thinks," and the media went crazy, and of course, people thought that he was going on another one of his crazy rants. Although, is Kanye crazy, or is he helping to free people from their mental prisons? That's what we're gonna cover in today's episode. Now, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe for more videos like this and other content that isn't so much focused on pop culture, but more so around bettering ourselves and really thinking clearly and having these higher leverage skills. Tending our mind like it's a garden and having control of our thoughts, what we think, and having actual evidence and background to what we think and why we think it is so crucial. Tending the mind is one of the most high leverage skills that you could have, because when you can control your thoughts and have critical thoughts, it becomes your reality and not a reality that other people put you in. Now let's return back to Kanye West. Kanye West is notorious for using different types of media and propaganda in order to pump up his albums, make his releases go better, but also he is known as one of the greatest rappers to have been created. Graduation was a phenomenal album, and since then he's helped produce and manage so many rappers that have come to life. Now, his newest tweet and the thing that kickstarted his both dropping album content as well as 2024 campaign run is about free speech and the freedom of different thoughts. Now, the greatest policing that has occurred recently, and I'm not talking about police brutality, but it's policing of the mind, policing of thoughts. See, we come from a society which wants to be able to say anything and wants everybody to be able to do anything that they want to do. Although the thing is, we then police people who want to think differently than we do. Doesn't matter if it's right, doesn't matter if it's wrong. The ability to think freely is a basic right. It's something that we all need to be able to have, because you can't tell someone they're wrong in thought. They have to come to their own conclusion with that. It's the same with any self-help movement. If someone doesn't want to be shown the answer, they're not going to see it. That's just the truth. In that 7-word tweet, "I love the way Candace Owens thinks," as Scott Adams said, Kanye West helped to free people from their mental prisons. Now, what is a mental prison? It's some type of categorization or categorical thought process that people typically associate with one thing or another and don't question where the fine line is or what someone is allowed to say when they fall into a category. For instance, Kanye West is a black rapper who started out poor and grew up to become this rich man who theoretically, right, should be Democrat, should be Republican, not libertarian, and not the ideology that he has. The same goes with Candace Owens, who's a black Republican woman who is preaching the message against what typically the norm in cultural society is. Now, we often see these things as antagonistic to each other. They don't like each other. The fact of the matter is, when you fight for peace, you're using a hypocritical statue in nature to fight for the thing that you want. Kanye West is clearly showing in his tweet threads that what he's trying to say is that you can have a difference of opinion from your fellow brother, from your fellow American, from anybody around. Really, you should respect everybody's opinions and what they think, but you don't have to agree with them. And that's the truth. You don't have to agree with everybody's opinions. You shouldn't. Remember, fundamental number 7 is question everything, and it is that for a reason. You need to question everything. You need to think, hey, does this actually make sense to me? Hey, do I agree with this person or not? But you need to respect what everybody says as well and what everybody thinks, because otherwise we become a society that polices thoughts, the worst policing known to nature. Whether you're a Democrat, whether you're a Republican, or whether you're someone who doesn't want to fit into one of the tiny boxes, it really doesn't matter. What does matter is that we take into account, understand what is going on around us. We've only had two political parties for the longest time, Democrats and Republicans. And as Nassim Nicholas Taleb, the creator of Black Swan, the writer of Fooled by Randomness, and Anti-Fragile talks about, is that what that did to us is make it so we become more and more polarized, because there's been no random party, there's been no random candidates, there hasn't been any variation in a long, long time. So what that brings us is to polarization and then, of course, demonization of each side. The more that that happens, the worse that we respect other people's thoughts. Why did I make this video? What is this video about? How does this fit into higher leverage skills and heightened living? Truth be told, respecting others' opinions and really getting an opinion for yourself, not allowing the predispositions that you were born into, not allowing the people that you hang out with to completely influence your thought, but to solidify your thought in who you are, the image of who you are, the nature of the reality around you, is one of the most important things that you could ever do. I'm not saying Kanye West is right or wrong. What I am saying is he is not crazy. He's trying to spread the message of allowing people to think differently. Think how you want to think, and I respect that, regardless of if it is in my favor or not. And the funniest part is when we see something we don't like in other people, we tend to criticize or condemn, but in reality, we're just seeing what we don't like in ourselves in that other person. And as much as we don't want to say that, right? Because we should accept personal responsibility for any and everything that goes on around us. And you need to take the responsibility and own up to the reality that you live into at this point in time. Whining, blaming doesn't work. When we see something in someone else that we don't like and we call it out and we are mean about it, that's our mirror neuron seeing it in ourselves and getting mad at what we have that we don't want to have anymore. So I'm going to end this video with this. Respect everybody's thoughts. Kanye West is not crazy. His new music is probably gonna be fire because he does put out great music. Yee vs. the People is actually a good song. I really like it so far. And understand that this world doesn't have to have everybody in agreement. What it does have to have is mutual respect and love for one another. So complete the oneness, be with each other, be happy, and understand that, you know, we need to respect everybody's thoughts. I want to thank you for watching this video. If you liked it or if it helped you in any way, make sure to press like, comment below with your thoughts. Even if they're not the same as mine, I completely respect whatever you have to say. And make sure to subscribe if you want to see more content like this in the future. I look forward to seeing you in a video soon. See ya.